spirituality, the way of being. Our mind is entangled in the past and future. Just drop the imaginary world. When your rational is immature, it doubts everything. The moment you believe something, you become blind to everything else. If you don't know anything, it's beautiful and joyful within yourself. A spiritual seeker is neither a theist nor a theist. He one who realized he does not know. So he is seeking. For example, can you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and go on? You'll be going on. You'll only become endless counting. That means that's not the way. Through physical means, you can never reach towards this boundless or infinite nature. This kind of life process is wrong way. We must pursue which is beyond the physical. Our mind is entangled with the past and future, so make your sense of involvement in the present. That is spirituality. We can reach this stage through meditation or concentration. We cannot easily attain spirituality because human's greatest enemy, karma, a lust or pleasure, doesn't allow you. Indian philosophy of life is always spiritualistic, not a religionistic, although it seems to be. Hindu philosophy is dynamic interplay of Trivarga and Moksha. Trivarga, comprising of Dharma, Artha and Kama, is the sum and substance of Bharatiya philosophy of life. It declares the supremacy of Dharma, the law of being, over Artha, wealth, desire for securing material pleasure, and Kama, every type of pleasure. It is the everlasting solution for all the problems of all human beings for all time to come, irrespective of their belonging or not belonging to any religion. The propounders of Dharma did appreciate that the fulfillment of desires of human beings was essential, but were of the opinion that unless the desires were regulated by law. Therefore, all the propounders of Dharma were unanimous that for the existence of an orderly society, peace and happiness of all, the desires are pleasures, and for material enjoyment, Artha should always conform to Dharma and be never inconsistent with it.